Hey folks, this is Matt once again, and want two reviews I'm going to end tonight on. One of them is Waxwork, which I think is a classic. I think this is a game changer, more than Cabin in the Woods. That's my opinion. If you like Cabin in the Woods, that's fine, but I like this film more. I like both of these films more. I think they do more. I think they're more interesting, let alone the creatures, you know, the monster mash, so to speak, at the end of Cabin in the Woods. I think Waxwork, the monster magic has at the end of that, is much better. And it's all practical, and anyway, that's my opinion. But Waxwork is directed by Anthony Hitchcock, written and directed by Anthony Hitchcock, who I don't always like his movies, but I do like Full Eclipse. That might be another one I re-review during this month. Other stuff that I like with this guy, I enjoy the films. I don't mind Hellraiser 3. The guy's done Sundown, The Last Vampire. He's done some stuff with Dolph Lundgren, among other films. But my favorites are Waxwork 1 and 2. And stars Zab Galligan. Zab Galligan from Gremlins 1 and 2. And you also have Deborah Foreman, who's been films like... I remember most from the original April Fool's Day, which I love. Basically, new wax museum, a group of kids find this wax museum, and they go in, and they see all these really lifelike wax figures, like the Wolfman and all these other figures. And what happens is the wax museum is headed by David Warner, who's a very wonderful actor. And if you go past the rope, you like enter this sort of new dimension. So, like, this one guy ultimately goes through, past the rope, and enters this dimension where he's in a forest, and he's like, he's not too bright. He's like, oh, I'm hypnotized. But the werewolf said, I don't want to give everything away. I wouldn't be able to. Because of the 15-minute limit. But, in that set, it's like, you have John Rhys Davies is this guy who's, like, in this sort of house in the middle of the woods. And it's a werewolf tale, and I don't say exactly what happens, but you get some really wonderful gore stuff. And the werewolf looks great. Look, it's practical. It's very well done. The low budget they had with this, they use it to so much great effect. But the film also has a good sense of humor at times to it as well. So at times it's pretty funny, but it's also pretty gory at times. You go, ooh, shit. And like I said, John Rhys Davies, who played Sala from Indiana Jones, the first three films, he's in that. And I'm not going to give away everything that happens. But like, you have a girl who goes through a rope, and you have a segment that involves vampires. And like, she finds this guy who's like, legs are all eaten up and really good practical effects, very gory. And she like takes on like these female vampires, and then you have Dracula there. You want to see what happens, check out that movie again. It gets very gory and very intriguing, like very interesting stuff that happens. And basically, Zab Galligan, Deborah Foreman, they don't know what happened to their friends. They thought maybe they left without them, but then it's like, okay, what's going on here? And for instance, you have like sort of a cop type of detective character, and he goes through, and then he's in sort of a situation where he's like in ancient Egypt, and it's the mummy. And I gotta say, this is one of the best mummy versions I've seen. And definitely, I haven't seen a gorier mummy. Maybe there is a gorier mummy version or segment out there, but I haven't seen it yet. Some fun stuff that happens there as well. And what I like is that it's different. You have a werewolf, you got vampire, you got mummy. They're very gory, which is I'm fine with. And practical effects, interesting idea that the wax museum, each figure is like entering a new dimension. I like the sort of blue ripple effect when you enter through sort of like this portal for each wax figure. And sort of pretty much the idea is like David Warner, he's supposed to get so many people, like whether you say their souls or whatever. And then pretty much they're all going to come to life. Which again, I think that Monster Mash at the end is done way better than the Monster Mash in Cabin in the Woods. That's my opinion. But like you have Deborah Foreman who are having to deal with pretty much Marquis de Sade, that sort of torture, but at the same time pleasure. Granted, that was my least favorite of the sort of worlds that they went to, but I was still fine with it. I liked a little bit where Zad Geller sort of finds, spoiler alert, folks, I'll put the water down when there's no spoilers, but I like the idea where Zad Geller realizes that, hey, this isn't real, you can't hurt me, go for it. And they try to hurt him, and they can't. And I like that idea behind it. I really thought it was a cool idea. And like a friend of Zad Galligan's is another great actor, Patrick McNee. Might have said that before if I didn't. Wanted to mention, because Patrick McNee and David Warner, great, capable actors. Good, like, good. Patrick McNee is good. David Warner is evil. Good actors on either side. And again, I like Zad Galligan, I like Deborah Foreman. One thing leads to another, and then pretty much Patrick McNee has brought his friends, and there's Zad Galligan there, and Deborah Foreman, and pretty much David Warren and all the monsters. And you have so many great references. I mean, you got a reference to the Little Shop of Horrors creature. You got zombies and the Wolfman. You got vampires. You got like a Frankenstein monster type. You got so many different kinds of creatures and just this free-for-all where left and right beating the shit out of one, killing the other. And like Zad Galligan has this sword that was his father's and he's like battling these monsters and... really love that idea. Really love the way it's shot. Well, I don't mean the way it's shot, but I mean the way... just the idea behind it and the fact that they use a lot of practical effects. Practical creature effects. It's like, you don't really see that too much nowadays, which is a shame. But it just made it a lot more fun, especially the ending. And... the last shot, they do leave room for a sequel, which actually they do pick right up with the sequel. But I love the film. I love the film for its idea. I love the portals, the areas that they go to, like the werewolf, the mummy and stuff. The practical makeup effects is great. I'm fine with the cast. Well, there's one or two problems with the cast, which I'll probably get into with a little bit of the spoilers, but... the monster mash at the end, seeing all these monsters come alive, it's like, oh my god, I've seen this as a little kid, all these monsters coming alive, and, oh yeah, Little Shop of Horrors, you have like this little creepy, I don't know, creepy, but, I don't know if it was like a baby, or a doll-like thing, or what the hell it was, or, yeah, like an alien-type creature, I just, really, it's like, wow, they could do this on a low budget? Imagine if they had a big budget, what they could do. But, you know, when you got a really cool plot, you got really great monsters, lots of different types of monsters. It's definitely gory, so if you're in the gore. Entertaining, fast-paced. To me, this is a game-changer. This is a film that's like, wow, this is not like... just your normal, typical, boring movie. This is a really, at times, pretty funny, pretty kick-ass movie, Waxwork. I love Waxwork. I wish they had done the special edition. I heard, again, that they were going to do special edition. Like, Anthony Hickox and Zad Galligan would have wanted to do a commentary. Why didn't that happen? That pisses me off. But anyway, getting to more spoilers, since I have a few minutes, spoilers from now on. What I love is like during the werewolf segment, like how certain people get killed, is really like, ooh, shit, you know, gory stuff. I love that. Or like during the mummy segment, you have this guy who is trying to pray, and the mummy walks up and steps on the guy's head and squishes his fucking head. Or the vampire segment where like the girl's dealing with these female vampires and it's like you have like wine like, I guess it's also kind of like a wine cellar, and she throws like one vampire chick, and she like gets impaled through the wine bottles, and like you see, you know, the bottles open, so not only is blood, but it's all this wine alcohol coming out through her body as well. Oh, I love the zombie section I didn't mention with Zach Galligan. He gets pushed into one, and it's pretty much a note to Night of the Living Dead, because it's black and white, and there's, you know, zombies trying to come after him. See, this is how you do zombies the right way. You have zombies, but they're not just for pretty much the entire damn movie. So you got your zombies, and you got your mummy, you got your werewolf, you got your vampire. And again, that idea where, like, she's trying to help this guy, and, like, she's fighting, and he's bumping into his leg. That's all, you know, there's, like, rats coming in the leg. That's pretty much, like, almost skin and everything's pretty much off on his leg. It's, like, really sick humor, I guess you could call it, but it was kind of funny. And again, the ending where, you know, all the monsters come alive in this big battle between the good guys and the monsters. It's like, wow, you know, they did this on a low budget. It just really shows how filmmaking in the 80s, again, this was 1988, how they could really, they went for it sometimes. They really went for it, like Reanimator. That's a low budget film. Not sure if I'll review that sometime this month. Maybe I'll say that for another time while I just review. You would call Reanimator a zombie movie, would you? Yeah, I would call it. But, you know, just save for a time where I review, like, a bunch of zombie movies or something. Who knows, maybe if I have time in October. But, and then, you know, Zach Galligan has to fight with the guy kind of, that was kind of from the Marquis de Sade sort of era, and they're fighting. So you get a pretty decent sword fight, and I like the score for the film as well. I thought the score was well done by, the reason I mentioned these names, I want to give them credit, Roger Bellin. My only problem with the film, like I was getting at, my only problem with the film is that Zach Galligan, his character, the kind of seemed like a rich snob at the beginning of the film. Like, very proper, you know, sort of rich. Like, the characters kind of seem like, some of them seem like rich snobs. Like, Zach Galligan, he's not like a blue-collar character. His character of Mark, is like from a rich family. Again, he kind of seems a little bit of snobbish at the beginning. But I warmed up to him because, again, I like Zach Galligan. And I definitely liked him more in Waxwork too, but I warmed up to him after sort of the initial snobbery. And the acting from the kids, it's not the best, but I've seen much, much worse. So, Zach Galligan, I warmed up to as the film went on. Ultimately, you know, I liked him. Deborah Foreman, she did fine. The rest of the cast did okay. David Warner, Patrick Meunier are the very capable actors. And other than that little problem with, you know, the acting is not the best, you know, still, you know, again, I liked Zach Galligan. I liked him in the film. I think the beginning kind of, you know, maybe if he was from a blue-collar class or something, I don't know. But that's a small problem, because ultimately, again, I liked the Zach Galligan there before. I still liked him. But I think the acting could have been worked a little bit better. But other than that, really enjoyable film. If you've never seen Waxwork, you're really missing out. My friend Michael Keane, if somehow you watch this, if you like monsters, you should check out Waxwork. Really should. You know, that's what you should do for October. It's October, man. Watch Waxwork. I know you got this DVD. Watch both of these. So stay tuned for Waxwork 2 coming at you in a little bit. And thanks for watching. Later.